Good morning, my dear children. I hope you all are fine at home. Be safe at home only. Don't go outside unnecessarily in this pandemic situation. So, remember, I'm your English teacher, Mrs. Palak Shwastha from St. Javis School, Hardoi. Today, we will discuss about the poem Jingle for class 3. But before going to topic, I would like to request you, if you are a new viewer, please subscribe our channel, like our videos and share our videos. So, let's start out the topic, Jingle. So first we should know who is the poet of the poem Jingle. So students, poet of the poem Jingle is Laura Elizabeth Richards. Very well known poet. Do you know, students, her house also very adventurous, based on the different themes. And she is a very well-known poet writer from US. And the poem what we are going to discuss, it is also based on fantasy land. So, let's start our poem. So the poem goes in this way. First line, please read it out. I think you have a look on the poem. You are watching all. First, you should know some words I have underlined with red color. First is dragonfly. Second is blue. Third is V. Fourth is tumbling. And fifth is meadow. So about these words also we will discuss later. Okay. So first line you read out can. I jumped on the back of a dragonfly. Students, this poet is in a dream. Do you know the means of jingle? Jingle. Jingle means, wordly means is, means a sound based on the rings, bells. But logically means also jingle is a thought which make a jingle sound in yourself. Means if you would have wings, what will you do, children? So let me know in comment box. But I will tell you what I will do. If I am having wings, I will fly over the world. I want to see everything upper. And I want to go everywhere if I have wings. So in this poem also, the poet has discussed about these things, that she had wings and how many things she had done. So first line, can you read it out? I jumped on the back of a dragonfly. So with the pictures, we will discuss the things. So first, about the first line, I jumped on the back of a dragonfly. Dragonfly, students, what I have underlined is a type of flying insect. Is a type of flying insect. I jumped on the back of a dragonfly. Matlab means if she had wings, she would like to fly on the back of a dragonfly. She want to put her button on the back of a dragonfly, then she wants to fly over the world. And she wants to fly up to the sky. She will not stop until she reached the sky. Then what she wanted to do? She wanted to pull down the cloud. Means cloud always covered the sky. So she wanted to pull down the cloud. Means nothing should be covered. She wanted to pull down that cloud which was hiding the blue. So here you can see, students, I have circled one word, blue. So blue means here sky. She wanted to pull down the cloud that was hiding the blue, means which was hiding the sky. And sky is our permanent roof, students. So she doesn't want that anything which will cover our roof. And all the V stars came tumbling through. V means very small stars family came tumbling through. Tumbling means, students, you know, means the things which suddenly falling down without any serious injury, but suddenly falling down, downwards, upwards, means moving here and there suddenly. She was expressing her thoughts about if she had wings, so how many things she wanted to do, she wanted to do with world. All the wee stars came tumbling to, means when she had her wings and she was jumping on a back of a dragonfly, she wanted to pulling down one cloud that was hiding the blue. And suddenly so many small stars family came together. When these families came together, small stars, stars also very naughty. She is showing the stars naughty in this poem. That when the stars watching her in the sky, they also started to play with her. The stars tumbled down. In this picture, you can see that the stars are making the line for tumbling down. I told you the means of tumbling, to fall down suddenly. In a value, in a large amount, and the tumbling round, they tumbling round also, means they started to play, to tumbling down and tumbling round. Stars also wanted to play, and when they tumbled down, stars means when the stars falling suddenly to the ground, they suddenly converted into flowers. As they touch the ground, means our ground, as they touch our earth, as they touched, they suddenly turn into the flowers. Means our world is so beautiful and stars are living in the sky, but when they touch the ground, suddenly they become flowers. So poet wanted to say to us students that our world is so beautiful. If we had wings, we can play with the natural things, and natural things will also play with us with a very naughtiness, just like a baby. As the stars touch the ground, they suddenly turn into flowers. So students, poet wanted to say to us that come with me children, come. So come with me children, so come with me little children, come. And down in the meadow, I will pick you some. Meadow also was underlined, students, in the poem. I told you, I show you. The meadow means also, do you know? A grass of field. A grass field. So the poet was saying to the students, to the children, as you are, as we were, that come with me. You come on the grass land, then I will pick you some, means then she will allow you to take some flowers from the ground. Which flowers, students? What already converted, which was earlier stars, then they converted into flowers, means she will allow you to take some flowers which was earlier stars, because the poem also based on the fantasy land, adventures. So do you understand that meaning of the poem? That the poet Laura Elizabeth Richards wanted to express her views, if she had her wings, so what she wanted to do, and if you will have a wings, what will you do? Please comment and tell your teacher that we will do these things. So explain the chapter, explain the poem. Again and again, watch this video. Let's start the activity. I told you the meaning, meadow, which was underlined, a grass field. First activity, difficult words. So difficult words, if you will learn again and again, so they will help you, they will improve your vocab. First, dragonfly. DRAGONFLY. Reached. Reached is the past participle form of the verb reach. To move somewhere. Okay. Pulled. PULLED. Hiding. HIDING. WEE. Number 5. Number 6. HITING. Number 7. Meadow. Next activity, students. Word meaning. The first word is dragonfly. Meaning of dragonfly, flying insect which is found especially around a pond or lake. Means the around any small water body. WEV means very small. Tumbling, to fall down suddenly. And meadow, a field of grass. One more word was there, students, which was underlined V. Sorry, not V. One more word was there which was underlined in the paragraph. Blue. So blue means mostly, you know, all you, I think my all students know this. Blue means color. Blue is the color. But here blue is specially used for the word sky. Okay, students, let's see the third activity. Write the rhyming words given in the poem. So if rhyming words, students, you know which sounds same, which sounds same in the word. First paragraph, I jumped on the back of a dragonfly, and second, and flew till I reached the sky. So fly and sky, first word, last word of the first line and last word of the second line matching together, rhyme. Fly, sky. Same way, blue, through. Third, round, ground. And last is come, some. They sounds together, these words are called rhyming words. Now we will do activity number 4. Answer the following questions with reference to the context. So first context is given, which I mentioned here with red pen. So students, we have to answer the questions what are given. First context we should read. They tumbled down and they tumbled round and turned into flowers as they touched the ground. So with reference to the context, first question is, who is the speaker speaking to? Students, here question is asking in the above context, who is speaking? So answer is, the poetess Laura Elizabeth Richards. Laura Elizabeth Richards means who has written this poem. Okay, poetess, why I have used to this word? Because female poet is called also poetess. Okay. Question number 2. Who are mentioned as they? Means as they. The word they in the context number 1. Who are mentioned as they? So answer is stars. Do you remember what I have explained previously? Now next context. So come with me little children, come. And down in the meadow I'll pick you some. Means poetess Laura Elizabeth Richards is saying here that she will allow the children, and she's calling the children that you come here, then she will allow to let them pick something. Okay, so question number 1 reference to context is, what is the sum here being referred to? So the word sum, which is under single inverted comma, can you see, students, this one? Okay, so what is the sum here being referred to? Flowers, which was stars before some time. I told you that when the stars touched the ground, then they converted into flowers. So question number 2 reference to the context, who is calling the children? Means in the above mentioned this here, Who is calling the children? You know very well. The poetess Laura Elizabeth Richards is calling the children. That children, you come, then I will allow you to pick some flowers from the ground, from the meadow. Down in the meadow. Meadow, you know? Meadow means a field of grass. So she is saying that I will allow you children to take some flowers which was earlier stars. So students, it's a very nice poem. Read and learn again and again and try to understand the meaning, the logical meaning of the poem Jingle. Okay, now be safe at home, don't go outside unnecessarily, and keep watching the video and share it as much as possible. Thank you.